The topic which I consider today is permutations and combinations. In this video, I will explain the tricks, shortcuts and formula of permutations and combinations. Let us move on to the first statement. It is permutations P is for arrangement of elements. And the second statement is combination C is for choosing of elements. Generally, people are getting confused between permutations and combinations. They are not able to choose which one to use to solve a particular problem. So I have mentioned these statements. Permutations is for arrangement of elements and combinations is for choosing of elements. Suppose if someone gives you some elements and if they ask you to arrange those elements in a particular order, then you have to go for permutations. Suppose if they ask you to choose some type of elements from the given elements, then you have to go for combinations. Okay, combination starts with the letter C and here choosing starts with the letter C. So combinations is for choosing and permutations is for arrangement of elements. Okay, now let's move on to the formulas. The third one, NPR is equal to n factorial by n minus r factorial. It is equal to n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 into so on n minus r plus 1. Just remember, NPR is equal to n factorial by n minus r factorial. Okay, let me take an example. It's 5p3. Here n is 5 and r is 3. Okay, substitute those values here, you'll get 5 factorial by 5 minus 3 factorial, that is 5 factorial by 2 factorial. 5 factorial is 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. And 2 factorial is 2 into 1. Now you just remove this 2 into 1 and 2 into 1. You will get 5 into 4 into 3. That is 5p3 gives 5 into 4 into 3. Hence, to remember this one, it is very simple. The n value is 5 now. Start with 5. Consider 3 values including 5. That is 5, 4, 3. Next 3 values. Okay, in decrement order. Just product them. That is the value of NPR. Okay, 5p3 is 5 into 4 into 3. Suppose if it is 6p3, what you will do? Start with 6 and write 3 values in decrement order up from 6. 6 into 4 into 5 in 5. That is 6p3. Okay. And the next one is NCR. NCR is equal to n factorial by n minus r factorial into r factorial. Okay, this can be written as n into n minus 1 into n minus 2, so on n minus r plus 1 by r factorial. Just remember, NCR equal to n factorial by n minus r factorial into r factorial. Let me take an example, 5c2. Substitute these values, n is 5, r is 2. 5 factorial by 5 minus 2 factorial into 2 factorial. It is equal to 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 by 2 factorial is 2 into 1 and 3 factorial is 3 into 2 into 1. Just remove this 3 into 2 into 1 from numerator and denominator. You'll get 5 into 4 by 2 into 1. So 5C2 is equal to 5 into 4 by 2 into 1. Simply to remember, just see this n value 5. So in the numerator, start with 5. Up to 2 letters you write, including 5, that is 5 and 4. You product them, okay? And in the denominator, you write the factorial of r. R is 2, 2 factorial. That is simple. If it is 6c2, you need to write 6 into 5 because the next decrement number is 5 for the 6. Okay, 6 into 5 by 2 factorial. R value is 2. Here 5c2, no? So I have written 5 into 4 by 2 into 1. This is the value of NCR. NCR is equal to n factorial by n minus r factorial into r factorial. One more, fifth one is NCR is equal to NC n minus r. Okay, this works good because you can reduce the amount of time spent in solving a particular problem. 5C3 is equal to 5C5 minus 3. Because n value is 5, no? 5 minus 3, that is 5c2. So the values of 5C3 and 5C2 will be same. Remember this, NCR is equal to N minus E equal to NC N minus R. And the sixth one is NCN is equal to 1. Seventh one is NC0 equal to 1. Remember, NCN is 1, NC0 is 0. Okay. I am really thankful to you for watching this video. I really appreciate your patience for watching this video. If you need any more videos, please subscribe to my channel and start watching my videos. They will be very helpful to you in the long run. Thank you so much once again.